Hi, my name is Esther, and today I start with an introduction. And this introduction is a part of the series of why you need to read the Word of God and how the Word of God can change your life. I will put the Bible in front of the camera. This is the Word of God. The Bible is the Word of God. And through this, my whole life has changed. And I say literally whole life. So I don't mean a little bit tiny part over here, or a little bit over here, or just a little small piece is changed. No, truly, I mean my whole life has changed. And because I was excited, I'm still excited, I think you can see that, I was excited and I started to talk with people about it. And I even gave sermons at the church. I have even coaching sessions, and I always tell people, please read your word, and let's start with reading with small scriptures. And well, most of the time I get horrible responses, and this is not to put somebody down or to judge anyone. It's just the responses I receive, and most of the time people will say, well, the Bible, well, that's huge. That's huge. It's so many pages in it. And how can I ever read the Bible? I don't understand it. Or they say, well, the Bible, is it not for pastors only? And when I read it, I truly don't understand it. Or they say, the Bible, that's dull. That's a dull, boring book. What do you want me to do with it? Or they say, well, the Bible, well, yeah, I read it. I know what's in the Bible. I know all the stories about Moses and David. And I get excited because somebody's saying they know the word. Then I ask, oh, why? Tell me. And how long did you, when did you read it? Well, they say, well, I think when I was 10 or 12 or maybe 15 or whatever. And then I try to ask, and how old are you now? And they say, well, I'm almost 50. And I said, oh, that's not the way either. So that they know it, but they don't know it right now or in their heart. They just have a little bit of understanding of it. That's totally different. I will come up with that later on in this part of the series, or later on in the series. But then you have also people who say, the Bible, I don't need the Bible. I go to church, and during church I take notes, and with these notes I go at home and read the scripture, and just read the scripture from my notes. And that's good, don't get me wrong, that's very good. It's just not good enough. It won't help you with significant change you are looking for your life. And I don't know about you, but when I came to Christ, I was messed up, and I don't have a religious background. My parents are not believers, and so I didn't understand the Bible or whatever. I didn't even understand Jesus. I thought, is Jesus Christ? Is Christ his last name or whatever? I didn't know. I didn't understand anything about it. So I was eager to learn. And then I found out that the Word of God can truly change your life. And I think I can explain it with this more. So if you bake a cake, you have put all the ingredients in, well, you have a nice, all the sugar in it, butter, or whatever you put in your cake. And then you just put it there. You don't put it in the oven. You won't get a cake. You have just mixed ingredients, but not a real cake that's tasty to eat. No, and I compare the Bible with an oven. Without the oven, no cake. And that's the same with life. If you want a changed life and a life as God has intended for you, you need the basic word and the oven. The oven. You need the Word of God. And my life, as I said before, was a big mess. But through the Word of God, I have seen a lot of miracles, and really miracles. And with miracles, the greatest miracle I received was character changing. I was messed up to the core. And my character is changed all because of his love and because of what is written in this word. And but also that I received healing, a visible healing in my body. I have never had a severe illness, and thank God for that. And but I had cold, or I had a flu, or I had back pain for years in my shoulder. And through the word of God, I could pray, and I received healing from all of these things. And but also I see a lot of healing with other people. I've seen migraines, people who are healed of migraines, people who had pain in their legs and in their bones, and all because of the word of God, I could pray for these people, and these people are magnificent. They are healed. And besides that, one of the other miracles, it's too much if I had to record it, a YouTube of all my miracles because of the word of God, I think I would be filming for 24 hours or long for a week. So I don't think anyone will see that. But anyway, one of my other big miracles is getting out of debt, because when I met Christ, I was truly in debt. I didn't even have to sometimes to eat during the day, and I would eat a Snicker. A Snicker will fill your stomach, and it's chocolate, it gives you energy. So I know what it is to have no money or no money at all. But through his love and through his word, I got out of debt. It's truly amazing. But let me say this real quickly. You need to be eager to learn his kingdom. So if you want to change for your own benefit, for your good, and for because you are sick and tired of this life, and that's good to be sick and tired of your life, but you need to have the desire to get to know him, and that it is his life you are looking for, not your own. So this is not your life you want to have prosperity for. No, it is his life living through you and living the life as God has intended it for you. Today I will only talk about one scripture. One scripture, and it is John 1. And I will read it out loud. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So in the beginning, the Word was with God. That's amazing, right? The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. So when God created the earth and the universe and all that's in it, he had the Word with him. I cannot put it enough in the grammar. He had the Word with him. So how can we think as humans who are followers of Jesus Christ, think we don't need the Word? If the Word was with him, and I think he even used this Word, and this Word we have now for us to read. And why don't you don't be too prideful or think, oh, I don't need it, I have the Holy Spirit, or I have a pastor at church. No, if God is, if this was at the beginning of the foundations of the world, how can you ever change your life if you don't have it? It's almost stupidity. I don't need to offend you, but I really want to make explain to you why it is important to read the Word of God. Because I have a lot of things to say, I will make a series of this. This was just a small, tiny, itsy bitsy introduction for big things about why you need to read the Word. Sorry, I'm stuttering. But one thing you can be sure, a change is gonna come if you read the Word of God. Truly, a change is gonna come if you read the Word of God.